So my lab is interested in cell morphogenesis. What that means is cell shape control, and how cells change shape. And one way to think about the importance of that is that the human body is built from a whole wide range of different types of cells who derive their function from their shapes. So for example, our body is wired with neurons. On the other hand, we're coated with skin cells, and those have very distinctive specific shapes in order to allow them to function properly. And so we've been interested in how cells acquire their shapes, how they're able to dynamically remodel to change that for the purposes of development, how we form in the first place, but also, I think more importantly, how things go wrong in disease. So we try to take a very basic and fundamental understanding of that, use that information then to develop strategies we hope which will become future therapeutic, or serve future therapeutic purposes to treat a variety of diseases. Ruth Kirschstein, is an important figure in promoting diversity in the bringing people from various diverse backgrounds into healthcare, biomedical sciences, and so forth, and to even be recognized. But she was also an exceptional scientist, and so to be even remotely recognized in that genre of scientists and leaders, thought leaders, is just a tremendous honor, one that I could not have anticipated. So my wife and daughters decided we needed to be doing a little bit more in the community, and we got involved in a community residence program that it was trying to meet the needs of youth from the Baltimore community who come from disadvantaged backgrounds. And through that, we brought a couple students into our lab for a summer. And over the course of that summer, we recognized that as we were trying to get them to be able to work in the lab and function in the lab, we started to recognize that there were certain deficits, and what we thought were rising sophomores and juniors in high school actually turned out to be academically on the third and fourth grade level. And so over the course of that following fall, the fall after that summer, we did a lot of introspection and said, can we really do this? And this is really a lab effort. So my whole lab, put our heads together, and we had conversations every day at lunch probably for a year on trying to figure out how we could make a program that would be really impactful. And that next year we took on a few more students, and then every year since. So we've now collectively over the years served close, by the end of the summer we'll have served 50 high school students. And from those now 100% that have reached college age have gone on and matriculated into four-year programs. Half of those are now STEM majors. And since that time we've now expanded the program. We were able to secure a big grant through the Health Careers Opportunity Program, which is sponsored by the Health Resources and Services Administration. And there's actually an interesting side story about that I can tell you later if you'd like. But with that grant, we were able to expand the overall program, create an undergraduate component as well as a post-baccalaureate component. And so by the end of the summer, we will have served 145 students across all ranges. The high school level is mostly focused on the greater Baltimore, Maryland area, although we have had a few students come to us from New Orleans and from Atlanta, but the undergraduate and post-bac levels are national programs now, and we recruit all across the nation, also U.S. territories and tribes. I'm new to ASBMB, and so I have attended an ASBMB meeting many, many years ago when I was a postdoc, and so I haven't attended for many years, and so this is my first one in a really long time, and so far I've been very impressed by the diversity of topics and the energy that I think the community is trying to bring to the field. We also live in a very, very important time where we as scientists obviously have to advocate for our profession and our efforts to try to solve problems. And I think all of the society is coming together to try to help communicate our goals and our objectives and frankly our responsibilities to our society is really, really crucial. And it's been really neat to see all the amount of attention that's being given here to those topics at this meeting.